Yes, good morning students. Today we will start our civics chapter number 2, diversity and discrimination. Diversity and discrimination, right? Now, first of all, we'll see what is diversity. What is diversity? See, there are geographical factors and even the historical factors which affect our diversity. Now you will say how geographical and historical. So geographical means there are regions which are lying near the sea area, which are lying towards the Himalayas, which are very cold, which are lying in between where plains are there. Different regions are there in our country, right? According to that, there are different living habits, clothing habits, people's behavior and historical factors, like in history, what happened? Historical factors, like we believe Lord Ram was born in Ayodhya, right? Then he went to Sri Lanka to fight Ravana. Right, so these are factors, different places, history also tells, and according to the geographical factors and the historical factors, these are the differences. That is, the differences means the diversity. Based on that, the differences come in the food habits, clothing habits, living habits, skin tone colors. People are sometimes, usually we see South Indians, like they are black in color. The people living towards the north of our country, they are fair in color. Usually, it's not mandatorily, but usually we have seen. There are people who are following different religions also. Like many of us are Hindus. There are few who are Muslims, there are few who are Sikh, few are Christians, few Jainism, and different kinds of religions, races, people all living together, right? So these are the factors which are responsible for the diversity of our country. Now, diversity as a point, it is sometimes it's our strength. It gives us strength that there are so many different kind of people, but they are living together. Living together and growing together. Sometimes this also becomes our weakness, that when we all start fighting among ourselves, that he is Hindu, he is Muslim, he is Christian, he is Sikh, and they should not be having the same kind of facilities, the same kind of friendship with them. So sometimes it becomes our strength, sometimes it becomes our weakness as well, right? Different factors affect our diversity. And many a times what we happen, we very quickly start having a kind of feeling about someone without knowing that person personally. And this feeling many a times is negative. The feeling, negative feeling about someone without knowing or understanding why the person is different from us, why that particular person is having a different clothing habit, a different food habit from us, we start having a kind of different understanding, feeling about that person, and this negative feeling or negative thinking about someone without knowing is prejudice. Right? Now, getting to the deeper meaning of prejudice, I'll explain you. See, prejudice actually means to judge other people negatively. Of course, it is negatively, not positively. Judging a person without knowing that particular person negatively, or to see or to inferior without knowing that person. Means I am superior, and that particular person about whom we are thinking or talking or discussing is inferior. Now, what is inferior? Is lesser than me or lesser than us in any ways. It can be the caste, can be the gender, can be the height, can be the wealth, it can also be the strength, can also be the gender. I'm a boy, I'm superior, and girls are like nothing. Even a girl can have the feeling, I'm a girl, I'm beautiful, boys are dumb. So this kind of feeling, always negative feeling, is prejudice, which actually should never be happening, should never be happening with us, right? This prejudice also deals in stereotyping them. Now, what is stereotyping? Stereotyping is where we think that particular kind of person about whom we are thinking or talking should be involved in one particular type of work. Like, if there is a girl, in olden times it was happening, like if girls were born and in the family, after the age of 8 or 9 or 10, they were not allowed to go to school and get education. They were kept at home, sit at make them made them sit. And why? To make them learn and do the household course. Why? Because in future also the girls, being the girl, will be becoming a mother, wife, mother, everything, and have to look after the family, should be learning and doing the same, right? Whereas boys were sent to school for education, higher education, and then for job, then for earning. Why? Because it is the job of a male member of the family to earn and not the female. This was a kind of stereotyping. Another example I'll tell you. Stereotyping is like up till olden age, whenever, means up till last 40 years, if a boy wished to cook something or he wanted to show his talent in it, he was assumed to be that he is not the kind of great boy, because what he wants to cook, he wants to design dresses, he wants to be a fashion designer. All these things belong to a female gender, and a man or a boy should not be involved in doing all these things. Girls should always be doing only the household works. But if the girl wanted to go in army, or even completed the training and now was going to join the job, the people around the family or the area, they were discriminating, or they were telling that these kind of work doesn't belong to a girl. They should be staying back at home and doing the household chores. So these are the stereotype thinking, which even now in few of areas we are able to see or able to sense. Right? Then coming to discrimination. Now, by the word itself, the meaning itself, you can understand discrimination of people according to the different ages, different gender, or different religion, or the means wealth. Some are poor, some are rich, some are high, means good height, they are short-heighted, they are fat, thin. There can be different kind of discrimination which we have in mind. Physical appearance, their financial status, and sometimes their different abilities. Yes, different abilities here means the physical disabilities, right? If a person is not able to see, a blind person, we discriminate him now. That particular person, he's not able to see. What he will do with us to while coming to see a movie, right? There comes a discrimination. If there is a person who is not having his legs, we will never call that person to come and enjoy a game of cricket with us. There comes a discrimination. So, assuming someone who will not be able to perform better in any of the things without knowing actually the person very much beforehand is prejudice. Now, there are people who also have special needs. Coming to the special needs, like here, I told you, physically disabled persons are there. Apart from that, there are people who are physically okay but need some special attention of a person, need some special care of a person. Why they want? Like a person who has lost his parents in an accident recently, in that period of time, that particular person is in special need. What kind of special need? It's a special need of emotional support. If there is a family who has just now faced a great robbery in their house, there they need a support, and there what kind of support they have, they want? They are in need of a financial support. So such kind of things, these all things comes in special needs. There are different things which are different in us, like discrimination. Diversity is living together, being different and living together. And discrimination means people having different opinion about different people because of their different qualities. For us who understand, we will say it as qualities, good qualities. But for others, what they think? They are having negative things in us, negative qualities. They are very much inferior to us, and we should not be having a good terms with them. We don't have to be friends with them. And so, such kind of people are left behind or aside, right? So, this is discrimination and diversity. In our next topic, in our next chapter, we will go further in the same.